गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन इंग्लिश क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू फिनिश द चैप्टर द लिटिल गर्ल। टुडे द कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी विल बी डिस्कस्ड अलॉन्ग विथ important question answer will be also discussed. So please, without wasting your time, take out your book and read out, find the passage, the paragraph that we have to finish, the leftover part of the story. Now, so as we have learned that the mother, Kazia's mother, became ill, and she and her grandmother was in hospital. So the child was left alone in the home along with her father. There she was arranging the Alice. The cook was putting bed for her, but she was afraid. What she thinks about? What I will do if I have a nightmare? Nightmare is a bad dream. Nightmare is a bad dream. A horrible dream or a bad dream is called nightmare. Usually, the dream in which you see the horrible things, the frightening things, the ghost, the fairy, or any horrible scene. So the nightmare. Bad dream. Fearful dream. Here she, the nightmare. Nightmare. She asked, I often have nightmares, and that granny takes me into her bed. I can't stay in the dark. It all gets whispery. Here you see the psychological part of the children's behavior is highlighted. A child who usually sleep with his elders, they are fearful in sleeping without anybody else. So here you see, the girl was at her mother and grandmother was in hospital, so she has to sleep alone. You just go and sleep. Look at the What are the reaction? What the father said? You go and sleep, Alice, pulling your other socks, and don't you scream and you yoke your paw. These are the words spoken by Alice. But the same old nightmare came. The butcher with a knife and a rope who came nearer and nearer. The nightmare was what? A butcher. Butcher is what? The butcher sells the meat, the kasai, jisko kehte hain kasai. The butcher with a knife and a rope. What the nightmare came? in her bad dream, what she saw, that a butcher with a knife and a rope came nearer and nearer, smiling a dreadful smile. Dreadful is a fearful smile. Dreadful smile. Fearful. Fearful smile. A dreadful smile. A fearful smile. While she could not move, could only stand still. And Kezia could not move, she could only stand still, crying out, "Grandma, Grandma." Here you see, Kezia was frightened, was fear-stricken. She was fear-stricken. Why she was fear-stricken? Because the familiar nightmare, the old nightmare that she usually experienced, the same, a butcher with a rope and a knife coming nearer and nearer to her, and she often stands up and cries. So here she cries, "Grandma." She woke shivering to see the father beside her bed, a candle in his hand. But when she wakes up, what she finds? When she wakes up, when she wakes up, she finds her father near the bed. Here you see what she finds when she wakes up. She finds her father near the bed. "Oh, a butcher," she cried. "Oh, a butcher, a knife. I want Granny." What she did? "Oh, a butcher, a knife. I want Granny." He blew out the candle, bent down and caught up the child in his arm. So here you see, can you see the words? See the paragraph. In his arms. Here you see. He blew out the candle. Who is he? The father. What he did? He blew out the candle, caught up the child in his arm, and carrying her along the passage to the bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed. He put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. "Look at father's love and affection. When the mother was in hospital, when the mother and grandmother was in hospital, Kezia was left all alone in the home. While sleeping, she had a nightmare. In that nightmare, she saw a butcher with a knife and a rope coming nearer and nearer to her. She cried, "Grandma, Grandma," and woke up. What happened? The father came. He came with a candle. And what he did? He bent down and blew out the candle, carried the child taken her to the bedroom. He lay down beside her. Beside is the next. We have two beside. Beside and beside. Beside and besides. Both are prepositions. That is next. Next to you, next to, and in addition to. Addition to. Here, besides myself, just next to you, bagal mein. And besides, that means in addition to. Beside this, I have three more pens. That means you have four pens. She came and sit beside me, next to you. So here, besides her, half asleep still. The father was half asleep, half asleep. Look at Kezia. Kezia was still in the grip of fear. Half asleep, still with the butcher's smile at all about her scene. She crept close to him. See, Kezia was still in the grip of fear. So she crept, goes close to her father, snuggled him, her head under his arm, highly tightly in his shirt. Snuggled. Please note down. Move into the warm. Snuggled. 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 Please note down. SNU.
Sir, what is the meaning of
butcher? 1 minute, beta. Ab ho gaya. Abhi pura tapik ko bata rahe. Snuggled. Is paragraph ko khatam karne diye. Main bata raha hu. Snuggled. That is moved close to. Close to another. Close to another, snuggled. Her head under his arm. What she did? She moved her head close to her father's arm, held it tightly to his shirt. This is the after reactions. So here, tucked up. The word tucked up. T-U-C-K-E-D. Tucked up. If you tucked up, you cover something very nicely. किसी चीज को ढक देना, कपड़े से ढक देना, चादर से ढक देना, कंफर्टर से ढक देना, tucked. Now what was your asking? Please say me. Which word you were asking? Please. Mutual?
Yes, sir, mutual.
Which paragraph?
Sir, in paragraph 11.
Paragraph number 11.
Oh, a butcher.
Wait. Butcher. Butcher is a kasai. One who sells the meat. That is called butcher. Butcher is a kasai. Theek hai na? A butcher who sealed the throat of a goat and sells the meat in the market. Bakri ko jabah kar kar jo bazaar mein meat ko bechta hai, he is called butcher. ओके
यस सर.
सो हियर यू सी बिसाइड एंड स्नेगल्ड एंड टक्ड अप थ्री न्यू वर्ड्स आर यूज्ड. टक्ड अप मीन्स टू कवर somebody with comforter or a cloth. A snuggle is going close. Beside means next to. Now, then the dark did not matter. Here you see. Now the little girl was feeling safe and sound. Now there was no fear. She lay still. Here, rub your feet against my legs and get them warm, said the father. Look at the father's behavior. All the passages, the father is presented as a disciplined, strict. But here you see how the behavior, the very behavior of the father seems to be changed. Tried out her sleep before the little girl. A funny feeling came over her. Poor father, not so big after all, and with no one to look after him. He was harder than grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. Look at the change in Kezia's behavior. Now she has experienced the warmth, the love and the affection that was showered on her. The love, the affection, the sympathy, the kindness which was that were showered or poured on her. Now she began to understand that the hardness was nice, and every day he had to work, so too tried to be MacDonald. And now she realized that her father cannot behave like MacDonald's because he was so busy. He was preoccupied with his own task and with his own work. So here you could see that now there is a change in behavior. Change in behavior. Change in behavior, here you see. Now she began to understand that her father is a busy person. She had to turn up all his beautiful writings. She started suddenly and sighed. What's the matter? Asked her father. Another dream. Oh, said the little. My head is on your heart. I can hear it going. What a big heart you have got, the father dear. Big heart. Look at them in the story. What a big heart. What a big heart. What a big heart. You have got, father dear. Father, dear, here you see, the last word, the last sentence of the story is enough to say that the child has understood that her father, here you see, father seems to hard from the outside, but here you can see that the parents' contribution, here the narrator or the storyteller has beautifully highlighted that how, that why punishment given by parents has love for you. It holds love for you. It holds sympathy for you. If parents punishes you, then it means there is a love, there is a sympathy for you. Here you see, as we all know, that parents are very fond of their children. They always desire to see them on the top. It's a very usual thing. It's a very common. Your father, your parents wish to see you on the top of the world. So, for this what they do? For this they leave no stone unturned. For this they leave no stone unturned. If your parents punishes you, it does not mean that they don't love you. They don't want to hurt you. They don't want to punish you. But what they want? They want to inculcate. They want to inculcate values, education, discipline, and so many things. Kezia has committed a mistake. Though innocently, she had stuffed the pin cushion with the paper that contained important speech. I agree that there was a negligence, but she should not touch those things that she is not aware about. So here you see, if her father beats her, he only wanted to teach her that she should value the importance of thing in the life. Tearing the paper, she should value. At least she, being a disciplined child, she should ask that whether she could tear that pages or not. So here the mistake that she commits was punished. So here we can say punishment given by her father had a lesson for Kezia, and before doing this kind of work, she would think twice whether the work that she was doing was right or wrong. So here you see change in the behavior. Kezia began to see her father as a human being. Look at the line, the last line of the story. What a big heart you have got, dear father, dear. Here, the very nightmare that terrified, that frightened Kezia, she started crying out of fear. When she wakes up, she finds her father near her bed with a candle in his hand. He asked her what's the matter. When she explained that it is the nightmare of a butcher with a knife and rope that has frightened her. What he did? He blew out the candle, bent down, caught up the child in his arm and carried her to her big bedroom. There, her father laid her on the bed and snuggled her, covered her with, and he lay down beside her. After some time, half asleep, she crept close to him, get closer to her head under his arm and held her shorts tightly. Now she felt comfortable. Here you see, she realizes that her father wanted her to understand his compulsion. What was compulsion? As his father was a busy person, he has his own responsibility that he has to discharge. He cannot be a man like McDonald's. They may be free or they may have enough of time. But so far as Kezia's father is concerned, he is a busy person. He has his own compulsion of life. But at the bottom of his heart, he was a very, very good person. So here we can say that father got it. So it is quite clear from the story that every father has love for his children, whether he expresses his love or not. Or if somebody expresses, somebody may not express. Fathers are not alike. There may be different kind of father. Some play with children. Here in the story, McDonald plays with the children, while other loves and care for them. They show their love to them working hard and giving them all the facility. Your father may be very busy, but busy for what? Busy for whom? He is busy and working hard to give you all facility. And they never expresses their love. But you should understand that your parents have deep love for you. Kezia's father belonged to second type. He did not believe in showing off his affection. He did not believe in expending excess of love, showing. He believed in showing his love by making her future more secure. This is very important. When she tore his paper unknowingly, he beats her harshly. But in the end, we find him very loving and caring. So we can say that every father loves his children, but the way of the love is different from person to person. Most of the fathers leave their dreams in their children. Their strictness is also kind to their love. Their strictness their discipline is also a kind of a love that they are exhibiting. So, this is what the story is about. Now, the story is finished. Now, if you have any query, please ask. I am unmuting and myself. Please put your question and ask. Or I am giving you one question. How did Kezia's attitude towards her father change? बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, केजिया का एटीट्यूड जो था अपने फादर के प्रति कैसे बदल गया. कम ऑन, कौन आंसर देगा? कम ऑन, केजिया का एटीट्यूड जो था अपने फादर के प्रति कैसे बदल गया? Come on. Say. Please note down this question. And you will send me. Please note down. Question number one. How did Kezia's attitude her father change? Having gone through. The warmth and the love, and having spent a single night with her father, she began to understand the love, the warmth, and the care for her father. She began to realize that his father is a different kind of a person. He loves her, but he is not that kind of a person who shows his love to his children. So here having spent a single night alone with her father was a keystone that changed the behavior of Kezia.